First, I want to say that Chris Benoit was my friend, if not my best friend. He was part of my family, the Guerrero family. To tell you how close he was to my family, to me, the morning that I found Eddie, when Eddie died, the first one I called was Chris Benoit. And after telling him, it almost broke my heart as much as finding Eddie. Because to see a guy that was hard as steel and chiseled and just a rock and never show emotion. And when I told him, he wailed. He wailed and cried and was sobbing, was uncontrollable, because Eddie was his best friend. The gift I was given when Eddie passed away was that I was able to be with him his last day and the last one he saw. Well, I was given another gift because last week I spent the night at Chris Benoit's house, and he's a very private person. He doesn't let people in, and he let me in. He let me into his home with his family and his dogs, fed me, put me up, and made me feel at home. And then we went on the couple house shows together on TV, went to dinner that next night, and we both missed our flights. I woke up to him banging on my door saying, come on, let's go, let's make your flight. So I was able to, he made it just barely. I missed mine, but I was able to get home. He called me to check up on me. I called him to check up on him. And it's so hard to go through this again with someone that I just respected so much as a person, as a friend, as a wrestler. To be in the ring with Chris Benoit was like, it was like there was no other person like him in the ring. When you got in the ring with him, it was such a pleasure, a privilege, and an honor to be in the ring with him. I thank God for the actual matches we were able to have together, because those were some of the best of my career. I was able to learn so much from being in the ring with him, and I remember after we were done working together, I pulled him aside and really thanked him and hugged him. Told him I loved him. Said thank you so much for just everything he's given me, you know, in the ring, in life. And we always left with a hug and a kiss and I love you. And that's something that he didn't give out very willingly. He didn't give that to people, but we gave that to each other. And the last time I talked to him, the day before he passed, he ended the phone call with, I love you, Chavo. I just want to say, Chris, you're my friend, man. I love you, and you're part of my family. I don't say that about people. I say that about you. Thank you. God bless you, man. And I feel for you, and I feel for your family. I'm so sorry. I thank you for the time we spent at WrestleMania. That was my kids and your kids. And they all play together, and I was able to go, the privilege and the trust that you had in me by letting me have your kids, and I took them with my kids, and we went to the movies together. I guess that shows me how you thought about me, Chris. And I thank you very much for that, for thinking of me that way, because I feel the same about you, and I would trust you with me, with my life, with my kids' lives. Because I know you, Chris. I know your heart, and I know what a great heart you had, have, whatever. But thank you, Chris, and thanks for being my friend, and I love you, man.